In this video, we're going to prove that the product of finitely many compact sets is compact. Before starting with the proof, let me remind you that if you want to support the channel, you can do so in many different ways. You can donate a small amount or become a member on Ko-fi. If you become a member, you get exclusive access to content. If in addition to that content, you also want to get merchandise, then you can join Patreon, where our monthly subscribers get stickers, mugs, t-shirts, and more. But if the mathematics merch is all you want, then you can check out our store, where we sell all the items. So now let's start with the video. We want to prove that the product of finitely many compact sets is compact. Before proving this theorem, we're going to need a lemma. This lemma is very important and can also be useful to solve some of the exercises. What it says is, we are in the product space of two spaces, where the second one is compact, and then if we consider x0 times y for some x0 fixed in x, and n a neighborhood of this set, then n will contain some tooth around x0 times y, where w is a neighborhood of x0. So let's make a drawing of what this is saying. We have y and x, and we are considering some x0 here. X0 times y is this set right here, and we say that n is an open neighborhood of x0 times y, so n is going to be a set around here. And what we will prove is that there exists a set w, a neighborhood of x0 in x, such that n contains the tooth w times y. Before proving the lemma, let me delete w because we're going to need a drawing. And the reason why this lemma that only works for the product of two spaces is useful is because we're actually going to prove the theorem for the product of two spaces. And then the rest, the finite product, will be directly using induction over this. So let's go ahead and prove the lemma. We said that we took some element x0 in x, fixed, and an open set in the product topology n that contains x0 times y. Now let's think about x0 times 1. This set, it's very easy to prove that it's holomorphous to the set y. I'm not going to prove this, but if you want, you can do it yourself. All you have to do is find a function that is a homomorphism between these two spaces. And so given that y is compact, then x0 times y is also compact. And because it's compact, given any cover of x0 times y, there will exist a finite subcover. That is a fact, and we can use it to choose a particular cover. We will take a cover, we will choose a covering that is formed by elements in the basis. So the basis for the product space is u alpha times p alpha. But let's take a particular cover. So take this one, such that u alpha times p alpha is a subset of n. So u alpha times p alpha are going to be sets in here. Now because x0 times y is compact, there will exist a finite subcover. So what we have is that this set will be covered by some rectangles. But only a finite amount of them. And if we check, this one projected into the x-axis would be the use of I. All these horizontal lines would be the use of I's. And all the use of I's contain x0. So if I take the intersection, let's do all the projections so that we can take the intersection. Okay, my drawing can be a bit off, but I think the intersection would be this part here, Well, let's call this W. This is an intersection of open sets in the X topology, so it's also open. And it contains X0 because all the U sub I's contain X0. So in our lemma, we had to find W such that W times Y was a neighborhood of this. Well, we have this. But now what we need to see is that W times Y is contained in this set N that we took originally. So let's prove that. For this, what we have to do is take X times Y in W times Y and prove that it's an element in N. So what we're doing is this tube here, this is W times Y. So I'm taking just any number in there, X times Y. And what I will do is consider this element here with the same Y coordinate. This will be X0 times Y. Well, X0 times Y was covered here by some of these elements. And so X0 times Y is an element of WI times PI for some I. So then Y is an element of PI. But now X is an element in W. And W was the intersection of all these sets. So this proves that X is an element in U sub I for all i's. And so X times Y belongs to UI times PI. And all these sets, when we chose the covering, we chose them so that they were all contained in N. And so all these sets are contained in N. And like this, we have exactly what we wanted to prove. So this proves the lemma. We now know that if we are in the product of two spaces where the second space is compact and we take N, an open set that contains X0 times Y for some X0 in X, then N will contain a tube around that set. Now let's see how we can use this lemma to prove the theorem. Like I said before, we're going to prove this theorem just for the product of two spaces, and then for the product of a finite amount of spaces, we'll just continue by induction. To prove that the product space is compact, we have to start by taking any covering of the product and finding a subcovering finite of that set. So we will take U alpha in the product topology, a covering of X times Y. And given X0 in X, we know that X0 times Y is compact. And so there will exist a finite amount of these sets that will cover X0 times Y. Well, now let's take N to be the union of all these finite sets. Obviously, N is an open set in the product topology and contains X0 times Y. Using the lemma, we know that there exists here in the X topology a neighborhood of X0 such that W times Y is contained in A. And we can do this for each X in X. So this W that exists is dependent on X0. Well, if we take the collection of all the W's that exist for each X in X, that is WX for X in X, this is a covering of X. But remember that X was compact. So then there exists a finite amount that cover X. And all the tubes WXI times Y will be contained in N. And each of those tubes is also covered by a finite amount of elements. So we have w x1 times y, w x2 times y, and so on up to w xn times y. All these sets cover x times y, and each of these can be covered by a finite amount of elements, and so that proves that the product space is compact.